in my face was probably a good thing.
Thank you.
Okay, please no Punterino. Can we all just survive turn one, please?
Thank you.
Gotcha.
Thank you.
Can you hear me a bit better now?
Car on the right. Clear on the right. Damage on the front of the car.
That's fucked it. I won't let me drive now. Right, hang on. I'm just gonna put myself in party chat so the game can't hear me. Going that one, that's an empty one. Chat audio switch to party, that's good. Right. Okay, so basically I use two cars. I use the Ferrari 488 GT3, which is the one I was just driving. And I use the Porsche Cup car, this one. No, well, this is a totally different game. The Nürburgring was on Forza 7. Similar car, that was the RSR. This is a Cup car, so there's no traction control, which is what I'm struggling with the most. So the setup I need to practice on, if I just set up is this one. It's Laguna Seca in, well, I want my Porsche really, hang on, let me. And the engine's in the rear and there's no traction control. This is the main problem I'm having, and I don't deal well with oversteer, so I much prefer a car that understeers. So basically I need a quick car, very slightly oversteery. I can't see what I'm doing now because my face is in the way. Obviously my car's orange.
Yeah, naturally.
Right, this is the official race server, so I should get the same conditions today that I get on race day. Which looks like it's 2 in the afternoon, track temperature's 25, so it's pretty warm.
That's not very warm, not for Laguna Seca. And of course, you're also going to get a lot of dust on there.
Green light, show them what you got.
Right, so let me show you. So setup wise, this is what I get. How far behind me talking on the phone is my YouTube at the minute?
About 10 seconds.
Okay, so you should be able to see now. I've got essentially two dry setups. I've got safe presses preset and aggressive preset.
Yeah, I need to improve the quality of the auto setup.
Yeah, or safe preset. And because I prefer a car that slightly understeers, I tend to go for the safe preset and then adjust from there. But I just want to go through the difference between the two. So if I go into safe, that's what I get. So PSI I don't need to worry too much about. I'm pretty good at sort of working that out. So the optimum pressure is between 27 and 27.5. But everything else in here I never touch, like never. So toe and camber. I don't even know what caster is. See the aero, the wing angle. I've got no front splitter, so I can't do anything with a splitter. My rear wing set at 6 on safe. Let me just see the difference between the safe and the aggressive. So, hang on. Safe on tyres. We've got 0.05 toe all the way around and 0.45 camber. So let's have a look at the aggressive preset. The aggressive preset, the toe and the camber is exactly the same, and the wing stays at 6. So I think the wing is the same for both, to be fair. Yeah, it is. So the safe preset. Yeah, there's so much stuff to play with. I mean, I've got ride height here. I've got wing angle. Brake ducts is more about temperatures, I'm not bothered about that. I've got damper settings, fast and slow. I've got anti-roll bars to play with. I've got wheel rate and bump stop rate. I don't know what that is.
Bump stop is where the suspension bumps out. The bump stop is on that suspension to stop it from completely compressing.
Right, do it. Right, so on a track like Laguna Seca, it's really bumpy. Yeah, so that bump stop rate is it's literally as low as it goes. Front's on 2, so that's quite soft. Back's on 4, which is fairly stiff. So this is the safe preset, so aggressive. 2 and 4, it's the same. I don't know what the difference is between the two, to be fair. I've got no idea. Yeah, right, let me have a look at my temperatures and do a couple of laps so you can just see what the car's doing. And then we'll come back to this then. But I'll use the aggressive and I'll see if I can keep it on the track. I'll tell you what, actually, let me just take a bit of fuel out, so I don't need 60 litres today. So that'll affect the weight of the car. Right, I'm just gonna put the telephone down a sec so you can see what I'm doing on YouTube anyway about 10 seconds ago, I'd say. I'll just have a little drive, see what happens. If you're looking at the screen, see bottom right.
Yeah.
So the green obviously is tyre temperature. So the colour is tyre temperature, but the numbers are obviously pressures. And the same with the brakes. So the green, like a nice dark green, is what I'm looking for those. and the pressures should sit between 27 and 27 and a half to be optimum. So just keep half an eye on that as well. We'll see what we're up to. Booted back to the pits. Right, I'm going to have a little play. I'm going to increase the pressures a little bit. Just didn't quite get to the 27 and a half that I wanted. Alright, the aggressive preset actually here feels alright. So when I tip in, the back's coming a little bit and it's taking the front round, which is nice. I know if I smack the power down, I'm really gonna struggle to hold on to that. That's fair. This is going to be about 2 seconds a lap slower.
Driver's
Okay. No, in a straight line. Straight line, it's okay. Definitely loses time in and out of corners just from the traction control thing. I've stuck my AirPods in, so I should be able to talk to you for about now. I'll have another little drive and we'll see what the temperatures get up to. So lap time wise, I'm looking for 126. 126.9, I don't be very happy with, but anything 127, mid 127s is fair. I tend to do 128 quite a bit. Giving if you touch a little bit of dust. Ah, it won't let me speak. Yes, so you don't want to use AstroTurf on the outside, you definitely don't want to touch the isn't it?
I've got light damage at the rear.
Damage, fuck's sake. Alright, I'm gonna boost the PSI on that left front. Like 0.5. It's a 15-minute race stint that I'm going to do, so we'll keep the setup as it is. I did. Must be weird, like, being 10 seconds behind on the TV. I'm warm. It's a good job there's no one else in the server, I'd definitely have rammed them. Is Matt with you? Yeah, well it's mostly like a bit of maths about your fuel. Right, 5 seconds, I'll get in the car. I thought you'd be playing this on the telly. Pretty hardcore binge watching.
Stay double file.
Yeah. How'd you get on yesterday? You're on.
No time pressure. Stay clear on the curves.
Shoulder physio moves. breaking point, I think. Yeah. I think when everything's good, that is the breaking point.
Too early on the roll. Not over yet.
God, this car, you do not want to lose it at all. It just does not like going in a straight line. I'm not going to get traction control, but what I want, coming downhill onto T1, I want maybe brake bias forward. Oh, I'll tell you what else I need to do. I've still got the Ferrari lock. That's a mistake. The Ferrari steering lock and the Porsche steering lock are different. It's 800 in the Porsche. That will help. That'll give me a little bit more time. Yeah. Brake bias.
Green light. Here we go again.
I think we've got a button for it. Traction control I've done. Increase, decrease ABS. Oh, I have plus and minus buttons. Increase and decrease brake bias. Right, so coming downhill into that first turn, I want the brake bias forward, don't I? But that's going to loosen up the back end for turning, isn't it? At the moment, so it's 55. Can you see it on the bottom right hand corner? It says TC off, ABS 6 out of 11, BB 55. So if I go forward like 5%, not 5% seems to quite a lot, because it goes up in 0.2 increments. Let's go 56. Let's see what happens. Let's see if I die. That's always a good indicator.
Thank you.
plan, I think that's like 60-65%.
Low down pressure, stay away from curbs.
ABS protection is blocking the front. Okay, when the ABS kicks in, you get like red and orange flashing for the brake bar. I've not noticed any instability. Yeah.
systems off.
Mechanical grip here. Dampers, that one. Yeah, that's where I was on.
Delay. Bit of a delay. Let's wait for a second.
Yeah, I mean, it's bump and it's rebound, that's it. And you get slow speed and you get fast speed. So on the right hand side where it says setup, the white box, dampers, the both slow and fast, so dedicated to enterprise, slow speeds control the damping during slow body movements and roll, pitch and squat depending on driver inputs, fast speeds control the damping over fast suspension movements and going over bumps, curves or similar undulations in surface. So I'm guessing if we get higher numbers, it slows the rebound. Fast bump, fast rebound, up. Okay. I'm going to take a bit of fuel out. Oh no, because I'm already on three. Oh, wait. See what I haven't done? Not put my number one quali brake pads on. I'm sure that's what that means. Okay, so what was it? 128.3 so far. No, it's dry or wet. Pushing. Yeah. Cannot get the turning right for that. I think this will be the last session. We'll do the race session because it's only 15 minutes and then I'm going to have to get off.
I don't mind me, I'm doing cooker.
Oh, are you making tea?
Yeah, come on.
I'd love a tea, that'd be wicked.
Honestly, don't rush off for me. I'm just sat there for a minute. I've not stopped, have I?
Scott says milk and sugar as well.
Cool.
Right, I've still got 18 litres of fuel left. I think I can get away with less fuel than that. Right, what... I'm going to just... Both fronts. Let's try that. I found my brake bias as well. I don't know if you've watched that, but I've turned the brake bias to 56. Okay. Okay, what was that? 27.6? 27.8. Okay, so 27, 27 will put me in the top 5 for the league race. I think pole's is going to be in the 26s. And I'm 3rd in the championship at the minute after 2 races. Yeah, I mean it's mostly consistency. When I get into a race, I'm quite conservative, but it means that I face the correct direction the whole time. So yeah, I'm more consistent than some of the other guys, but some of the other guys, when they push, they're much quicker than I am. But yeah, they turn the car around quite a bit. Yeah, if I can get the 27s again, like a low 27.
Going double fire.
Yeah.
damage at the front of the car.
Severe damage. Thank you. further than 56.
Thank you.
getting there. That's, yeah, that's pretty much what I was looking for today. That's, what, more than 58? Session then, let's see if we can get that. Session. Obviously, I'm the only person on the server at the minute, so it's not going to matter too much. But 27.5. Am I happy with a 27.5 for this championship? I suppose I should be. The pit entry, I suppose, is my best chance to play with the brake bias, isn't it? So I don't want to do it in the braking zone because that'll screw things up. Oh, this track is hard. I don't know why they decided to put this one in.
Stay in the fire. Come on, go. Thank you.
Excellent job, man. What a race. P1. Bring it back home safely.
Right. We've made progress. I'm in the 27 and a halves when I pull it together. Oh, I'm back now. I think that's enough. Cool, right, well, thanks for your help. Do you want me to stream tomorrow's race? Watch out your text beforehand and yeah, you can let me know. Alright, well thanks for your help. I'll speak to you later. See ya. Bye.
Right.
Yeah, that was hard.
Right. Why is it harder than
usual? Just this track and
the
yeah.
Track with the difficult one.